Oh, wrong game, guys. Sorry about that.
Oh. How's everyone doing? Welcome to Painting Middle Earth. This is part two of our Painting Tauriel, the Silvan Elf episode. And tonight we'll be picking up where we left off two nights ago. And as you can see here, this is where we stopped in our last stream. I painted Tauriel's base. I painted the wood that she's standing on, and then I put some shrubs on it, and I painted the ground she's going on, so you can see how it turned out. I think it turned out really well with all the highlights and everything that we added to it. So tonight we're actually going to paint the model Tauriel herself. And to start out with, we're going to paint her leggings, and we're going to do that with a little bit of Incubi Darkness by Citadel. This is like a dark green slash blue color. So we're going to water this down. And before we get started, I'm going to share this with the Nashville Miller Strategy Battle Gaming Facebook page. So give me just a second, and then we'll get started. Hope everyone's doing well tonight. Sorry for starting out late. My computer did not want to start up. It was said it was already sleepy and wanted to go to bed, so it took forever for it to boot up, but I had to restart it a few times and finally got going, just running a little bit slow. So, share your link real quick. I'm going to share this with the other groups real quick. I'm drinking a little bit of Baja Blast here tonight with my Rogue One cup. That was this movie theater company in Texas called Alamo Draft House, based out for the Alamo. So I'm drinking some of the Baja Blasts tonight. My favorite Mountain Dew. All right, I'm going to share this with the Facebook group, and then we'll get started. I've got that shared. I'm going to share it on my Facebook page as well. All right, so now I've got all that shared. We can go ahead and get started. And if you're joining us, go ahead and post a comment in the chat, and that way I know you're watching. All right, so to get started, I'm going to use Incubi Darkness from Citadel on the Tauriel model, just to show you again where we got on Tauriel from last time. So last time's episode, I painted the base, and you can so I painted the log that she's standing on, and then I put some shrubs around the base that just make it more lifelike and realistic. So you can see there, and it turned out really well. For the base. So now we're gonna be painting the actual model tonight, that for Tauriel. And so first we're gonna do is we're gonna paint the leggings that she's got. So right here where her thigh is at. And so we're gonna do that with a little bit of Incubi Darkness, which is like a dark green color. I'm gonna shake up the paint real well to get it mixed. Sorry for starting the stream late. My computer did not want to start up. I had to reboot it a couple of times for it to want to get going. So, but anyways, we'll go ahead and get started. Dip my paintbrush in the water, get it fluid. I'm just going to put some of the paint over to the side, away from my water droplets, so I can bring the water into the bit to the paint and get it to the consistency that I want. Okay. Yeah, so first we're going to start with her legs. All right, so I've hit the first leg that you can see there. Again, using Incubi Darkness by Citadel Paints. So I'm going to hit the second leg now. And then I'll do a second cut on it just to make sure its color stays there. And if you're joining us, drop a comment in the chat and let me know what you're up to tonight. Love to hear how you're doing and what you're up to. So you can see I've got the first leg done with Incubi Darkness, and I've got her kneecap right there done with the Citadel going up into the top of her the strips. Now I'm just going to kind of very carefully go around the boot. That way I can make sure I hit all of it. And behind her legs kind of tough to get to, but luckily most people aren't going to be looking at behind her legs, so don't have to worry about that too much if you can't get to it. But it's kind of hard to get to. Hey Lee, how you doing, buddy? Good to talk with you again. Thanks for joining us. What are you up to tonight? All right, so I've got both the legs hit up now, as you can see there, and I'm gonna hit the first one that I did, so that way I can get a second coat of paint on it and make sure I get that dark green color that I want for her leggings. Oh, recovering. Was it hot or what are you recovering from? Probably the least thing I like about some of these malls is they can be really hard to get to in certain spots. All right, so now that we've got her legs done, I'm going to let that dry, and then what we're going to do is we're going to do a highlight along the length of the legs, so up and down where the calf is at, to give us some highlight. So that's looking good, so I'm going to wash my paintbrush off. Oh, nice. That's good news, Lee. I'm glad that you're, I'm guessing, is Christian your son, I would assume? I know Christian can also be a girl's name, but that's great that your kid won their soccer game. And nice for ice cream. I'm sure the ice cream felt good after running around in the hot heat. All right, so I'm gonna let this paintbrush dry while I get my next paintbrush out. All right, so now I'm gonna get another really thin paintbrush because we're just gonna be really just touching up along the lengths of the leg here. And so for the highlights on the leggings, what I'm gonna be using is called Thunderhawk Blue. So it's gonna give it like a bluish green color by Citadel. So I'm going to shake this up real good. And then we're just going to, like I said, just go up and down the front of the legging where the sun would hit it, just where that piece of clothing would be a little bit lighter than the rest of it. I don't think you saw on the stream, Lee, I started the stream with my mask on. So we had Borderlands 3 came out tonight, and so I had to pick that up. Another part of the reason why I'm running a little bit late was the game I thought was getting released at 8, but didn't get released until 9, so that was my bad. Anyway, so yep, I'm going to use this Thunderhawk Blue now to highlight the leggings here, and we don't really need a whole lot of paint because we're just doing the one strip here with this color. And it's very similar to Incubi Darkness. So you won't really, that's the nice thing about the shading is you won't really be able to tell a whole lot that it's different. There we go. All right. So now that I've got that watered down a little bit, I'm just going to go see the model here. I'm just going to go right up and down the leg right here. And then I'm going to go up and down the leg on where her knee's at right over here too. Just to give it a little bit of differentiation. Oops, accidentally. I was like, why does that look so similar to the last color? It's because it was the same color. I put Incubi Darkness back on where I wanted to highlight instead of the Thunderhawk Blue. Silly me. Try this again. I can definitely tell the difference in that one this time. I'm just going to add a little bit of water to it just to water down the paint a little bit so that way it's nice and thin. So we can add a couple of layers of it. All right, so you can see there, I just hit where the kneecap is at. So I put a strip right down the leg right here. And then I put a strip right where the knee is at over here too, just to give it some differentiation. All right, so now I've got that done. We're gonna start with one of the main colors of green that we're gonna do on most of her uniform. That's gonna be with a Castellan green, which is a darker green, and then we can go with lighter colors from there. But that'll be our base for her leggings, or not her leggings, but for the boots and her arms and a lot of this model's body, so. This will be a color that we'll use a lot of here. Yeah, so that was it was fun to get to dress up. The character's name is Psycho. I don't know if you've played Borderlands, but the character that I dressed up as is called Psycho, and I won the costume contest tonight, so I got some prizes, which was nice, from the store manager. All right, so I'm gonna wash that brush off. Now we're gonna start with this is Castellan Green by Citadel Paints. We're gonna use that. All right. Let me shake it up a little bit. So Lee, how are your Rohirrim coming along? Have you started on them yet? All right, I'm gonna open this bad boy up. We're probably gonna do about a 2-to-1 water here. I'm gonna thin the paint out. So we can add multiple layers. We don't want it to be too watery to where It's not, the water's not consistent, or the paint's not consistent. Very slowly. Yep. I've done painted Theoden, and I started on Aemir, and I haven't finished them yet, but they are also going very slowly. They're just not on priority right now. As you saw from the Facebook page, my main priority right now is painting up the Battle of the Five Armies troops. So, got a lot of work to do. Yeah, kids and family and life in general can be a big time eater. I definitely understand that, bud. So here I'm just painting. I'm going to start with her boots. And we're going to put some golden lace on them later. Kind of make them stand out. I can't wait to see your Theodred once you get it done. That'll be sweet. I haven't actually seen anyone play with Theodred. I don't know how. I know, most Rohirrim armies base their army around Theoden, but probably for Theodred, I don't know if Theodred might be better just as a story model. I don't know how competitive he is. But definitely a cool model. I'm hoping they re-release him. Alright, so I've got her first boot painted now. You can see there in the camera. Now we're going to go to her second boot. Okay. Maybe people just don't play with him as much because he's not as accessible as Aemir, being that he's you can't get him hard. He's harder to get compared to Aemir. Oh, okay. There's a few differences, I guess, with him. I haven't looked at his profile a whole lot. So I haven't played Rohirrim yet. All right, so there's her second boot. See there? I'm going to add a second coat of the Castellan green now to her boots.
My silver shoes have run down to the sea. Under cloud, beneath the stars.
All right, so there's her boot there. I'm going to hit the second boot now.
I turn the glass to pass and lead home. I cannot tell. We came all this way, but now comes the day to meet you away. Many places I've gone, many sorrows I've seen, but I don't pray, nor will I.
All right, so there's her boots. Now what we're going to do is we're going to paint her same color with the skirt. These little flaps, I call this a skirt right here, but the little flaps of right here, right above her leggings. Strips, I guess you would call them. I'm excited to see what new missions we get tomorrow for our Battle Companies League. Had a lot of fun with it, and Jake's done a great job putting it together for us and doing everything. Thanks, buddy. All right. Well, I will see you later. Thanks for checking in. So I got the first two strips painted right there, and I'm going to just keep on going around in a clockwise fashion. My cat's meowing. What? Definitely feels good to finally get some paint on this model. I've been playing with her quite some time. And I love the model. I like the dynamic pose that she's in. I'm happy to get this model finally have some paint on her to continue to play with her on the table. All right, and there you can see I've now got a first base coat of the Castellan green around all the leather straps that are around all her skirt here. I'm going to add a second base coat where I've already hit just to, again, give it that color and make it really defined. On her side here now. Off the base for just a minute so I can get the other side parts of her that are hard to see when she's on the base. This is a really nice green too. I've just recently started playing the Batman miniatures game, and this would be like a really nice color for Poison Ivy. Something definitely to keep in mind. I'm gonna paint her up. All right, so there is what her skirt looks like with two base coats of the pastel and green here. Now I'm gonna hit her arms up here with the same green. We're back on the base. So I got the one sleeve, now I'm going to go work on her other sleeve now. I'm just going to hit her color up with this color. All right, so there you go. See, I've got both of her sleeves now. Now I'm going to do a second coat on her sleeves. Thank you. All right. So there's that. I've gotten two coats of green on all the parts that we're going to do green in now. So we're going to, I'm going to wash off my brush with the Castellan green. Wash my paintbrush off. So I've washed that paintbrush off. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to take Caliban Green here from Citadel Paints, and we're going to mix it 50-50 with some Lamia Media, which is also from Citadel. And what we're going to do with the 50-50 mix between Caliban Green and Lamia Medium is we're going to mix this and put it into the recesses of where her cloak is at, so that way it'll be a little bit darker in those recess areas to give it, again, some more definition here. So I'm going to mix both these up. Not going to need a whole lot here, just a little bit, because we're only hitting up the recess areas. And I'll just give it a slight difference in the color. I'm going to save this paintbrush, and I'm going to take a pipette here and stick it into my Lamia Media and just add a drop to my paint that I just put down. Oh, my pipette real good from the Lamia Media. I'm going to mix the two together. All right, so now we're just going to hit the recessed areas. All right, so doesn't really make a whole lot of change here in this part. You can't really see it. But it does add a little bit of definition if you look at the detail, at the model in closer detail. So. All right, so that is with the one-to-one mix of the Caliban green and the Lamia media, and I just put it in the recesses around the model. So like right in this area right here, you can see a little bit of differentiation than kind of where the flaps fold over I did as well, just to make it a little bit darker. Again, just trying to give it some definition to the outside that's hit by light, like doing it under the skirt tails and yeah. So I'm gonna wash my paintbrush off there. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna highlight the edges of the model with Lauren Forest, which is a lighter green. So we'll hit the edges up of the skirt and the arms with the Lauren green, just again to kind of give it some more 3D look to it where it's all just one color, give it some depth perception. Just a second. Looking up something real quick. All right, so now I'm going to take my Lauren Green here from Citadel, and we're going to hit the highlight. We're going to highlight the edges of the boots and the flaps. I'm going to give this a good shake. going to use a really thin paintbrush here. This is a super fine detail paintbrush by Army Painter that I'm going to use. If you want to try and use the exact same thing that I'm using here, I've just been mainly using the super detail and the super fine detail by Army Painter for these paintbrushes. I don't actually think I've ever used this color before. It's the first time using the Lauren Green. And we're going to do about a 2-to-1 ratio of paint to water here. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the boots areas. So where you have like the lacing there, I'm going to hit that up just very slightly with the Lauren Forest green, and then I'm going to go up to her flaps and I'm going to highlight down the edges of that. Also hitting the edges of the boots. Just kind of give it, again, that fine detail here. And hit the very tops of the boots. So you can see there. I hit the laces on the boots, and then I hit the very tops, tips of the boots, and then the very tops of the boots right up here. I did a right on top of those again to give it some definition. All right. So now we're going to go down the length of the skirt flaps. You can do this all around the model. Just going to hit the edges. And also just going down the length as well. I'm just hitting the tops of her arms where the sun would hit it. Just give some highlight there. All right, so there you can see what I did is I highlighted the tips of each of these skirt pieces and then also went up and down the length of it in one straight line to, again, give it some definition and highlights, basically. All right, so I'm going to wash my paintbrush off there. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to start with the leather pieces of her armor that she's wearing. We're going to do this with Rhinox hide. Since she's wearing hide armor, we'll hit the hide, start with a dark Rhinox hide, and then we're going to highlight from there and go lighter. So typically with these models, you want to go from dark to light. Just again, showing recesses and give it some depth again. Grab a drink real quick. All right, so now we're gonna do is take my Rhinox hide and we're gonna hit the leather up. So that'll be the breastplate, that'll be I don't know what the name of that is, but basically the arms. So that'll be the leather parts and then also the quiver that's, or the her sword holder on the back of her back where she holds her daggers at. That'll also be hit up with the Rhinox hide. I think she's turning out very nice. I'm pleased with how she's looking, and we're about halfway done with it now. All right. Need to get some more of these fine detail brushes, so that way I can have more than just four. But four is good. I won these four at a painting contest in Arkansas. John Billy and I went to a tournament called Mirkwood Madness, and I won a painting award for my Moria army that I had painted with the help of John Billy as well. So that was cool that I got these paintbrushes for that. All right, so again, we're gonna mix the paint to water in about a 2-to-1 mix. All right, we're going to start with her breastplate. I want to hit this piece twice because we're going to start dark. So with this dark brown, it's going to get down to the recesses. Bracers, thank you, David. It's going to get down into the... How are you doing, buddy? I didn't see you joined us. I'm going to hit the breastplate up. We're going to do two coats on the breastplate, so that way it gets really into the recesses. And then we'll go lighter from there, to kind of like what we see in the movie. What are you up to tonight, David? Good to talk to you again so soon. That video conversation was fun. We'll have to do that again soon with the group. Looking for your hand drill. What are you drilling tonight? Getting up her back now, where her breastplate is at. Huh. Well, let me beam you mine over to you, so that way you can use my hand drill. And then you can just beam it back to me. If only that technology existed. All right, so I've got her breastplate coated now. Now we're going to do her bracers. Thank you, David, for the word. It was on the tip of my tongue, and I couldn't think of it. And if you're Yeah, definitely Star Trek. I love Star Trek. But if you're wondering, like, wanting to know how I, you know, do this and you don't want to go back and watch the video, I have all the steps for how I painted this model written down. So I'd be happy to send them to you. And once the video is over with, I can see if I can add that to the video or not. Put that in the detail section. So the point is if you ever do this again, you would hope that you could do the same. Say you like how it turned out, you want to be able to replicate it. So taking good notes is important for doing that. So I wrote down all the colors, all the paints that I planned on using tonight for this model before the stream. I'm just hitting up the other bracer. All right, so that is the first base coat for Tauriel. I've got her breastplate and her quiver on her back. Not her quiver, but her knife holder on her back, and then her bracers on her arms. So I'm gonna go back and do that a second coat now, just to give it make it a little bit darker, and also just give us that color that we want. Since I watered it down, two coats will make it darker than just one coat. Go figure that, huh? All right, so I'm going to hit our bracers up again. All right, so there we have it. We've got her breastplate painted, and we've got her bracers painted, and we've got her knife holder right there in the back painted. So now we're gonna do the highlights from what we just painted on. We're gonna highlight the leather areas with Doomball Brown, which is a lighter brown color. Basically going to hit up the raised regions. Right. Grab a drink real quick. All right, so I'm going to shake up my Doomball Brown. And again, we're going to just go over the raised areas of the bracers and her chest plate. And then once we get done with that, we're going to highlight over that too. Just layers on top of layers to give it that definition and the difference that we're looking for. Again, doing this in about a 2-to-1 mixture of paint to water. Water down the paint, and then I'm just mixing it up well to make it homogeneous and where it's all the same consistency. All right. doing well, Brown. We're really hitting up all the areas that we had the Rhinox hide on. That is to, again, it'll make the recess areas darker and the regions that are not, that are hit by the light will not be so dark. Get the bracers up now. I'll let that dry. You can see what it looks like with the Doom Bull Brown in it now. Just makes the brown leather a little bit darker. Then once we get done with this, we're going to go with XV88 to highlight the raised regions of that on the leather to just give it the just those light parts on the raised regions before the sun hits it. See how she looks now. Let her dry a little bit more. All right, so I'm going to wash off my brush now, and we're going to hit up the front of the upper breastplate with Zandri dust, and then we'll hit up the regions on the gauntlets as well. We're going to use, a paint called XV88 by Citadel. This is like a sawdust kind of color. And we're going to hit this up on the raised regions. And It's just going to be very light. You don't want to smother it. We're going to do about 2-to-1 mix again with the paint to water. We're just going to hit the raised regions of her leather here. Hey, buddy, have a good night, David. Thanks for dropping by, and I will see you tomorrow. Thanks for hanging with us. Looking forward to seeing you, buddy. All right, so now that we've highlighted the regions of her breastplate and of her gloves, her bracers, we're going to do her bow now, which we're going to do in Gorthor brown, like a light brown color. And we'll be about finished in the next 30 minutes, and then we'll call it a night. All right. We're going to take our Gorthor brown, and we're going to shake it up really good. Do about 2-to-1 mix in water. All right, so we're going to hit our bow up with the Gorthor brown. You know what? I'm actually not going to do it with Gorthor brown. I'm looking at it now. I'm actually going to do it with dry aardvark for her bow. We will use the Gorthor brown as a highlight. Shake up our dryad bark really well. We don't need a whole lot of it here. Just doing the bow. Do about 2-to-1 mix again. Paint to water. Going to paint the bow and the arrows with the dryad bark. You can see her bow. Again, gives it some nice contrast in the with the dryad bark. We're going to do a second cut of it. Make it nice and dark. We're going to do that on the bow and on the wood of the arrows. All right, so there's her bow. You see, looks good. Just gonna wash the brush off. That brush dry. All right, so now do we go with Gorthor brown for the highlights? Do we go with Mournfang brown? On the bow. Actually saying Steel Legion drab. So I'll do Steel Legion drab for the highlights of the bow and the arrows. Since we're just doing the bow and arrows here, we're not going to need a whole lot of paint. I'm just highlighting the edges. Bow. All right, so I just hit the edges along like where the bow goes down, and basically all this top part I just did a strip of the Steel Legion drab there on the bow to give it some highlights. Also, we want to get the bow arrow. Right. I hit the very top of the arrow where the sun would hit it, just again to show some differentiation between the bow and the arrows. Now we're going to paint Tauriel's hair, and we're going to do this with Rhinox hide as a base coat. Going back with Rhinox hide, this is what we did earlier with the first coat of the hide. We're going to give her hair, start with a base coat of this dark brown. And we'll highlight it. All right, so there is a base coat of Rhinox hide on her hair. And it gives it really that dark brown that we want to start out with. Go back with a second coat just to make sure I got all the regions. All right, I'm gonna let that dry over here. We're gonna highlight the hair again with Steel Agent Drab. We're just gonna go down the lengths of the hair to give it to hit the spots that we want. And then once we do that, we're going to wash the hair with Seraphim Sepia. That way it gets into the recesses and you can differentiate between the tops of the hair and the recesses. All right. Blowing the paint a little bit, that way it'll dry a little bit quicker. Grab an air drink. All right, so now that I've hit all the raised regions of the hair, as you can see here, with the Steel Legion Dreb, I'm going to now do a Seraphim Sepia wash over the hair. The shade. I'm also going to do the wash on the breastplate. Get into the recesses. So I'm going to use Agrax Earth Shade. It's going to be a little bit browner. And I'm going to do this wash over the pretty much everything, over the breastplate and over the gloves. because the Seraphim Sepia wasn't quite dark enough for what I wanted on the breastplate. So this will give it a little bit more brown. And we can go back and highlight it. I love Earth Shade, and just the shades in general are just so good. I like Nuln Oil. It's I like magic in a bottle. So I'll wash that off. Now we're going to paint the face and her hands with Cadian flesh tone. I'm going to take the make this up real good. This is Cadian Flesh Tone by Citadel. It's a layer. We're going to do on the face and on the hands. I'm going to hit their hands up. I'm using my super fine detail brush here for the skin because it's so. I want to. Don't want to not hit anything. You don't want to hit. The other hand. All right, so now I've got her skin painted with the Cadian flesh tone, as you can see here. I did both for her hands and her face. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create a wash mix, basically with 50% Lamium media and 50% Bugman's glow. And we're going to use this to shade the skin areas. I'm going to mix up my Bugman's glow real well. Grab a pipette and grab the Lamium media, and I'm going to do a 50-50 mix here to make kind of like a wash. That's not Lamium media, that's the Calvin Green. Lamium media here, just going to add a drop. This to my Bugman's glow. Going to make a wash with it. Wash my pipette. Mix up the two. All right. Now I'm going to hit the skin areas with this as a kind of like a wash. All right. So that's what she looks like with the wash. It's going to just kind of get into the recessed areas, make the eyes a little bit darker. Then we're going to go back with the kitty and flesh tone again and hit the brows, the lips, basically all the raised regions of the skin. Again, to give it kind of a two-tone color to the face. Let this dry, and then once that back with the kitty and flesh tone and hit the raised regions of the skin. And then once we go from there, we'll highlight the regions that we other raised regions to give places where the sun's hitting. All right, so now that this is dried, I'm going to hit the raised regions of the skin with the kitty and flesh tone again. This will be, we'll be hitting the brow, the nose, the upper lip, basically just like everything but the eyes. I've hit her face, I'm going to hit her hands again. All right, so now that we've hit that, we're going to now go back over the eyes with a watered down version of Pallid Witch Tone. Pallid Witch Flesh, I should say. And we're going to use something called Deepkin Flesh here, which is similar to Pallid Witch Skin. So we're going to use the Deepkin Flesh as a highlight, again, on the skin on the raised regions, just to give it that light elvish skin tone. We are almost done. Alright, so we're going with Deepkin Flesh here. And here we're just going to really water down the Deepkin Flesh and just hit the highlighted regions of the skin that we just previously hit. Let that dry, and then once that dries, we'll do another layer. We're just really trying to, this is a really thin coat of the Pallid Witch Flesh / Deepkin Flesh, and this is what will give us that light, white, almost really white skin for Tauriel. But we're getting there. Do another coat now. Just really thin coats on all the raised regions of the skin. Let that dry. We're really just trying to very slowly get towards the light white skin that we're finally trying to get to, because you don't want it to be too harsh, because then she'll look like a ghost. But you just want it to be just right. So that's what we're doing here. But thank you all for staying and watching with me tonight. Looks like this will be a 3-hour stream on Tauriel. But I think she's turned out pretty good. I'm going to go back and do some things after the stream just to fix some minor things that I'm seeing that I want to get fixed to get it to where I want her. But she is tabletop ready now, which I'm happy. She's a fully painted model. And I think she looks really nice. Just gonna go back and do a few things just to really just time consuming things, but to get it right where I want her. Cat snoring. You're just about at the tone that I wanted her at. Go back with a little bit of Katie and flesh tone and hit her eye section. All right, now what we're going to do is we're just going to do the final highlighting details for Tauriel here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint gold on the hilts of her swords. I'm also going to paint just some gold trim on her bow. And then I'm also going to put iron breaker on her daggers here. So we'll start with the iron breaker first. I'm also going to go back with the, with the dryad bark, and I'm going to hit some areas of the arrows that I missed that I want to get. So I'm going to take the dryad bark and some areas of the arrows that I missed. All right. I'm also going to look and see what color her arrows were. I can't remember if they had red, if the feathers had red or yellow. Let's see here. Yeah, her arrows do have a red feather, so we'll use Mephiston Red for the feathers. We'll start with the daggers. We'll put some Iron Breaker on the daggers to make them nice and shiny. And then we'll go back and add some gold detailing to Tauriel. We're going to go with Iron Breaker. Again, a layer from Citadel. Making this Iron Breaker about 2-to-1 with water mix. We're going to add this to her daggers. Right. Let that dry, and then I'll add a second coat. Now we're going to paint, now that we've done the daggers with Iron Breaker, we're going to use Jelena Gold, and then we'll do that on the quiver, and we'll also do it on the handles of her dagger, and I'm also going to add it to her bow just because I think that'd be a nice touch. So So we had using Jehanna's gold by Citadel. It's a layer for the handle of the dagger. The used it on the back of her knife bag, and then I'm also going to do it on the laces of her boots and on the tips of her bow, just to give it some definition and some differentiation. We're going to do three thin coats of this. That way it'll really give it that gold color we want. All right. All right, so I've hit the blade. I'm going to hit the back of her sword pouch. I'm also going to hit the tips of her bow. And lastly, the shoestrings on her boots for the gold. All right, guys, we are almost done here. I'm just doing a few more touch-ups. Just trying to highlight her face up a little bit more. Hit up a little bit of green where I missed on her collar of her shirt. Just to get rid of some more definition between. So what I'm gonna do here, looking at the model, I'm gonna hit the green right there, right above where her chest piece ends up. That way you can see a definite green area. Son of a bitch. All right. So, guys, we are just about done tonight. I'm going to go ahead and close this off here, but you can see, and I'll put some pictures on our Facebook page of how she looks like in the end, as it's really kind of hard to see here on my camera. But you can see she's got nice definition, lots of different details. So there you have it. I think she turned out really well. I'm just going to add and change a few things and close it out, guys. So starting this weekend, let me show you who we will be starting on next. Our next painting video. So starting this weekend, we will be starting on the man, the legend, Thranduil. So we'll be painting his mounted version with the elk starting this weekend. So stay tuned for that live cast video. That'll be going on Saturday night and on Sunday night. So we'll be working on it this weekend. Hope you can join us. And if not, you can check back on the video when it gets finished. So thank you all for joining tonight. Have a great night. And if you are in the Nashville area, please join us tomorrow night for our game night at Grand Adventures. We'll be getting there starting at 5 p.m. and playing till about 10 or 11 p.m. tomorrow night. So I look forward to seeing everyone then. Have a great start to your weekend, guys, and have some fun times in Middle Earth. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.